they were asking me questions about what I was doing at school and just couldn't get the words out. Really started to stammer. And from that day on, it's kind of been with me.
For me, my heart would start racing. My palms would get sweaty. And then you start to feel a little anxious.
Like this panic, like fear came over me and I couldn't stop it. And I literally felt like my heart was going to explode.
When we were living in Germany, and I was probably in fourth or fifth grade, and somebody borrowed my tennis racket and broke it. And it was just horrible. I got so angry and so upset, and you know, the world was over, and it was inappropriate.
Just feeling like things were just not going to get better, and just probably at its worst, it's just that complete lack of hope and just not really wanting to continue on anymore.
His first assessment of me was that I had bipolar disorder, and at that time I was rapid cycling, which I'd be manic, depressed.
If I'm feeling manic, I might think that a certain girl likes me, and like I'll hear her voice saying, "Hey, you look good." I feel depressed, and I hear like, "You're nothing. Hurt yourself."
I was afraid the government was watching me, so I didn't even feel safe in my own room. And my dad noticed I was acting weird and strange and saying, "I can telepathically talk with my neighbors." And I was very emotional, and he said, "You're not doing well. We need to take you to the hospital."
And then I ended up locking myself in a bathroom and thinking that the mirrors and the walls were cameras. I took toothpaste and shaving gel and thought that the walls were like my cameras.
As the attacks came, it was as if they took that information and used things to try to attack me, like an employee was actually spraying a chemical in the hallways during work hours that made me sick.
Well, I've had fibromyalgia for 35 years now. And the pain had progressively got worse, and I'd tried the various medicines that are approved for it. There's three, I think, and none of them did the job, you know, got rid of the pain.
Status was horribly important to me at that time. And when I took the first sip of the vodka, it was so smooth going down. This was a drink that exploded in my mouth, if I could say that. That Bloody Mary, I think, was the beginning of what turned out to be an out of control spiral downfall.
So I was diagnosed ADHD when I was in high school. When I felt, I said to my parents, "I can't even read a page. I can't even, read the assignment because my brain is just so scattered." And I describe it as a tornado in my head, and I can't just grasp one idea.
The compulsions change all the time. They're not, I know that a lot of people with OCD like check the same things over and over. And for me, it's like these, it could be anything. It could be, I have to go in this door of the train on the L, or I have to skip this step, or I have to not eat the rest of what I was eating.